Hey guys, RageRapperZ here, and today I'm going to show you how you can unlock the built-in administrator account on Windows 10 even if you don't have administrator permissions. So the method that we're going to be using most likely will only work on a personal computer, and it is unlikely that it will work on, say, a school or college computer. So the method that we're going to be using does require that you either have an installation USB or CD for Windows 10. Now, if you don't have an installation CD or USB, then I have made a video before on how to make an installation USB. So if you want to look at that, there will be a card in the top right hand corner, or there will be a link in the description. So once you have an installation USB or CD, you then need to plug it into the computer, and then you need to come to the start icon down here, and you need to click on it, and then you need to click on power here. And then you need to hold the shift key down on the keyboard, and then you need to click restart. Now it's important that you hold the shift key down, as this will stop the computer from restarting and will instead bring you to this window here. So at this window here, you then want to click use a device, and then you want to select your installation USB or CD. So for me, my installation USB is this SanDisk Extreme USB here. So I'm going to click on the SanDisk Extreme USB. Right, so now the computer is booted up into the installation USB. We're now going to click next. And then we're going to click repair your computer down here. So I'm going to click repair your computer. And then you need to click troubleshoot. And then you need to click command prompt. Now in the command prompt, you then need to type regedit. So that is R-E-G-E-D-I-T. And then press enter, and that will open up the registry editor. So now in the registry editor, we're now going to click on the local machine directory here, and then we're going to click file, and then we're going to click load hive. Now we're going to press this PC, and you now need to find your main storage device. So it will most likely be the C drive, but for me it is the E drive, so I'm going to open the E drive up. And the file system inside of the drive should look like this, and you should have a file called Windows. So now, like I say, it will most likely be the C drive for you, but mine is the E drive. So once you are at this directory here, you then want to open up the Windows file. And you then want to open up the system32 file. So here it is here. And then you want to find the config file. So here it is here, you want to open config. And then in the config file, you then want to find the file called SAM. So that stands for System Account Manager. Now this is the database that stores all of the local users' passwords in an NTML hash. So we're going to click on the SAM file, and we're then going to click open here. And now you can name it whatever you want. I'm just going to name it offline underscore temp. And then I'm going to click OK. So now if we go into the local machine directory, as you can see, there is now a directory called offline temp that we just created. So whatever you called it, you then need to find the directory, and then you need to open it up by clicking the arrow on the side here. And then you need to open up SAM, then domains, then account, and then users. Now in the users, you then want to click on the file named 00001F4. So it most likely will be at the top, so I'm going to click on it here. And then in the file, you then want to click on the file named F, and you want to double click to open it up. Now in the hex editor, you then want to use the arrow keys to move the cursor down to the line that says 0038. Now once you're down at this line, you should be able to see that there is the number 11 right there. So we're going to be changing the 11 to a 10. So we're just going to press the delete key on the keyboard, and then we're just going to press 1. So now that has been changed to 10. So now we're going to click OK, and then we're going to collapse the file system back down. So we just have the offline temp directory here, and then we're going to click on offline temp again, and we're then going to click file up here, and we're then going to click unload hive. And then we're going to click yes. So now if we close this window and we close the command prompt, and then we turn our computer off and we then turn it back on again. So now the computer is booted back up. If we now come back to the start menu again, and we then click on the user accounts up here, As you can see, we now have an account named Administrator, so if we click on the Administrator account, if it's your first time opening it up, it will most likely say hi and welcome, so if we click sign in, then it should automatically sign us in and there shouldn't be a password. Now, as I have signed into the account before, it doesn't need to set up, but if it is your first time, it will most likely take a few minutes to set up. And there we go, we have now unlocked the built-in administrator. So guys, if you like the video, don't forget to hit the like button. If you disliked it, hit the dislike button. Subscribe for more content like this, and I'll see you another time. Bye.